There was a film franchise called Carry On, mainly during the 60s and 70s. It was cheaply made, had horrible jokes.
Vic, darling, I think I'd like a roll.
Great, let's go upstairs.
I mean a sausage roll.
Oh.
And it could never, ever, ever be made today. But what if it was? What if we could recreate the magic with a similar outline today with popular social media stars? Why not fully-fledged movie stars? I'll tell you why. Smash that subscribe button and let's break this down. So before we can get into the main reason you clicked on this video, the Viners, the YouTubers, the TikTokers, etc. It's okay, I know that's why. I doubt you have even heard of the Carry On films. So let me get into that briefly to give you some context and then let's reinvent this franchise for today's audience. The franchise focused on a group of actors that were put into a scenario. They usually all work together, sometimes interchanging between the cast. The regulars, however, included Sid James, Kenneth Williams, Joan Sims, Charles Hartree, Hattie Jakes, and Barbara Windsor, as well as many more. Some of the films included Carry On Cruising, where the cast go onto a cruise ship, Carry On Up the Jungle, where the cast goes up the jungle, Carry On Cowboy, Carry On Screaming, Carry On Teacher, and so on. You get the drift. I don't know if I need to say this, but the cast play different characters every time, they don't just play themselves. People love these movies, including myself, because it showed actors that, although weren't the best actors, and generally played slightly different versions of themselves, you just like seeing these people on screen together in different scenarios. The sets were also cheap, usually filmed on a soundstage. And the turnaround on these productions were extremely fast, almost like a film version of a 90s SNL sketch. I'd consider these actors to be similar to social media stars today. However, I want to stress that the majority of this cast I haven't really seen act, but I like their personalities on camera. They're all creative and would bring a similar vibe to what they did with the original cast. Carry On Abroad is the film that I'm going to be taking inspiration from. So today, imagine with me. It's the 90s. The film opens with a TV commercial about a new resort opening in the Australian hinterland. And in order to boost the local area, they have an amazing package deal to boost tourism in their small town. An all-included trip, flights, transportation, food, you get it. The characters are introduced with their different lives and different reasons to take this trip. A couple that are trying to bring back a spark to their relationship. Josh Peck, probably the biggest actor on this list, and Amanda Cerny. She's pretty funny and would mix with the style of humour we're aiming for. An immature man who lives at home, whose parents bought him this package to get him out of his comfort zone, meet new people, and have his first vacation by himself. If you're thinking, this sounds like someone I know. Yeah, Jonah. Perfect casting, right? Just kidding, Jonah. I actually think you're one of the best parts of the vlog. A newly single lady who's naively optimistic, who needs to get away from it all in the cold of the UK to get a bit of sun. There's this TikTok and YouTube personality called Holly H. So funny. She would be able to bring a blind optimism to the cast as well as being super funny. Humour is key in this film. Cocky brothers that get a bit of a reality check out of their environment. The Paul brothers. As a producer, I'd be concerned that they wouldn't be team players in an ensemble cast. However, I'm hoping that in this scenario, they'd be good sports. They're both funny, both can act, and both have great comedic timing. Shane Dawson. Shane brings out a bit of an intense energy, mainly there to make things a tad uncomfortable. He's also been known to work with multiple other social media personalities. This is the main thing you really want in a film like this. It's the cast back and forth and camaraderie that really holds the film together. It always looked like on the set of the Carry On films that everyone was having a blast. So they all make their way to Australia and they meet their tour liaison for the trip. I'd cast a social media personality called Ian Zaro. I hope I'm pronouncing that right. He's funny, he's outlandish, and he would gel with the cast. He meets them all at an airport hotel. They hop on the bus and make their way to the resort. All they have is the brochure and find it doesn't look finished. And as they start to check in, they notice something. The bellboy, the reception, the owner, all seem to be one person. Jason Nash. He seems like he could play the kind of guy that's barely keeping it together. And if he didn't meet David, that might have been the case. Now, throughout their stay, they notice things in the resort. No windows, the plumbing isn't the best, things like that. Throughout the trip, there's hijinks, problems, and the holiday goers bond over the conditions of the hotel. Now, remember, this is set in the 90s. Why? Well, if it was set today, there would be smartphones and a hell of a lot of bad reviews. But it's opening weekend, and they're quite isolated. The owner of the hotel is so stressed that his hotel is not going as planned. So, like in Carry On Abroad, he plans one last big farewell party, hoping to leave the guests with a last memory that might make up for the horrible experience. The guests don't originally have fun due to their horrible experience, but eventually, they party, they have fun, they dance, and they all get way too mellow. Whilst this is happening, however, it's been raining heavily, and shocker, the foundations of this small resort weren't the strongest. And all the weight of the guests dancing along with the weather, the hotel starts starts to fall apart. And although the owner is having a small breakdown over it, the guests seem blinded by it. They don't care, and they're having a ball. As the hotel collapses, they all evacuate. The film then ends with the guests all meeting up once again a year later in Australia at a restaurant, probably because they got refunded. They're all so much closer, and the film ends with the title card, It's Down Under. The Carry On films are comedies, lighthearted without too much depth, an escapism, a different world. As I said, what made most of the Carry On films wouldn't work at all in today's context. But if you take just the right amount of inspiration, I believe it could be a viable franchise for today's audience. It wouldn't go into theatres, it would be a Netflix release. I love this franchise, and you don't really get these kind of films anymore. It's either a film that's too serious, too lazy, or an astronomical budget. But if you get it right, just right, you could recreate magic that was Carry On. Thanks for watching. I'm sure you haven't seen the Carry On franchise, but if you have, make sure to leave a like. Leave your comments below on who you'd want to cast, if this was happening, or if there's anything you'd like to add. I'd love to hear your ideas. Make sure to smash that subscribe button, leave a like, and remember, wherever you are in the world, wash your hands.